Hello friends, good morning. We are going to start our new topic today. And yesterday I have conducted a test also. But some students are also need to prepare. And please complete your all topics. If you will complete all topics per day, your work burden will reduce. Otherwise, in the last, your work burden will increase, increase, and increase. So please, you complete your topic per day and revise that topic, same topic, whatever topic I'm completing, revise same topic. Okay? And if you have any query and doubt, please ask. Otherwise, this doubt will be only in your mind and you will never clear this doubt. Okay? We have done yesterday, we have started second chapter, and I said that second chapter weightage is 10 marks. Clear? In the second chapter, we have completed introduction of economic development, economic growth, limitations, characteristics, and then after we have done this, all types of indicators. I have started means of the indicators. Then these four indicators are in detail in your syllabus. Other than four also, which we have to write only name whenever in question 2 marks. Write indicators of economic development. That time we have to write this 4 and last 4. Okay, this total will be 8. There's eight indicators we have to write. This 4 and next last on the last page 4 also given. So this total 8 we have to write. Okay. Now next one is we have completed economic growth of the national income as an indicator. Its meaning, its limitations, and all other countries related growth rate of national income also we have completed here. Then I have started what do we mean by the growth rate of per capita income, tabulation explanation of various countries, 6 countries, the tabulation explanation we have completed. And then after we have completed limitations of the per capita income as an indicator of economic development. Okay. Now next one is the limitation of per capita income also we have done. These are 4-5 limitations which we have completed. Then after I have started PQL, okay, that is quality of life, and PQL, that means physical quality of life, not index. Quality of life and PQL means of the quality of life, means of physical quality of life. And aspects are which are included in the physical quality of life, not index. Okay, not index, only physical quality of life. This we have completed. These are total 10 points which we have completed. Okay, after that, next one is physical quality of life index. What do you mean by the physical quality of life index? Its meaning is over. Physical quality of life index is given by Morris, and its weight value is 0 to 100. It is a type of the index, and in this 3 determinants are there. These 3 determinants will be measured a country's human development, human economic development. Okay, and then after I said that it has given by Morris in 1970 in the overseas development. Okay, and that time he has given, and UNDP has accepted. Clear? And physical quality of life has 3 determinants. The 3 determinants are extent of education, life expectancy, infant mortality. Their meaning also we have completed. Reason for selection or reason to only these 3 determinants which are selected for the PQLA. Okay, there's all 3 reasons and their explanation we have completed. Now next one is the formulation of physical quality of life index. Physical quality of life index formulation. In this formulation, we have completed it. This one is remaining. Formulation of physical quality of life index. From here, I will start in detail. Okay. Physical quality of life index will formulate. I said that these are 3 determinants. First one is extent of literacy. Okay. Second one is life expectancy. Last one is the infant mortality. Clear? These 3 aspects. In this, these 3 determinants will measure if we are going to formulate a country's PQLA. That time we have to measure these all 3: literacy, life expectancy, and infant mortality. And this all three have 100-100 weightage. How much weightage? This all has given 100 weightage. That means literacy rate also have 100 weightage. This one, 100 weightage. Life expectancy, 100 weightage. Infant mortality rate also 100 weightage. So this all three have 100 weightage. Clear? First one. Second one. On the basis of performance of these determinants in that country is graded only 0 to 100. Whatever value we will get, this value will be between 0 to 100. Okay. Next one is the total of these grades of three factors are summed up. These three. 100 literacy, 100 for the life expectancy, 100 for infant mortality rate. If we will be graded this, then after we will be give this weightage, then after this all three will be added. Whatever value, suppose India has got 60 literacy, then 60 for the literacy, life expectancy has got 61, or infant mortality rate weightage has maybe 50, then this all will be 8. Whatever total we will get, it will be summed. That means this all three factors are summed. Total we will get, then after it will be divide. Whatever total or summed up we get, it will be divided by 3. Divide by 3. Clear? It will be divided by 3. Total will be divided by this 3. Okay? To drive an average. Why? Because we want to get an average. Why? Because of its value is 0 to 100. So whatever value we will get, it will be in the 0 to 100. Clear? The data so derived is identified as PQLI. Whatever data we will get, the data will, after divide, after division, okay, after whatever sum we get, it will be divided by 3. Then whatever value we will get, that value will be identified as a PQLI. Clear? It is a formulation. How we will get the PQLI? It is a formulation. Now next one. Important aspects. Important aspects of PQLI. If PQLI is close to 100, whatever value we will get, it is 100% sure that value will be 0 to 100. Okay? So close to 100, that means what? Better performance of this all three indicators in of PQLI of this country. If a country's PQLI value is close to 100, then we will say that country has better performance of these three indicators. These three indicators, that means what? Literacy, life expectancy, and infant mortality. Clear? So these all three have better performance in that country. Clear? Next one. If that is the close to zero, then it will be better or bad? Bad. Okay, if that country's PQLI value is close to zero, then we will say bad performance of this all three indicators of PQLI in that country. Okay, next one is the PQLI will be always 0 to 100. What we are discussing, important aspects. Okay, this value will always 0 to 100. Why? Because of its value only this. So whatever we will measure, between this value only, that value we will be get. PQLI can be used to compare two states. We can compare two states within the country, okay? Or two different countries of the world. If we are going to compare, we can compare these two states. Suppose Gujarat and UP. What is the PQLI of Gujarat and what is the PQLI of UP? We will compare it. Which country has close to 100, that country will be better performance. Same is, if a state PQLI is higher, then that state has a better performance. For an example, Gujarat PQLI has 70. For an example, just only for example. Gujarat PQLI is 70. And UP PQLI is 60. Then which has good performance? Obviously, Gujarat has better performance compared to UP. Okay. suppose we are comparing three states of a same country, Gujarat, Bihar and UP. Suppose Gujarat has 80, okay, or UP has 60 and Bihar has 40. So which has better performance? Obviously Gujarat has better performance of this in a country, and UP has second rank and last one rank has Bihar, like this. So we can compare two states, more than two states within a country, or two different countries like India, Japan, Pakistan, Nepal, Bhutan, Sri Lanka, Norway, these all countries. We can compare their better performance or bad performance with the help of the PQLI. We can give a particular rank to them. Okay, suppose 150 countries selected, and in this 150 countries we will be compare this all according to their PQLI. So two countries and more than two countries, two states, more than two states within a country can be compared easily with the help of the use of the PQLI. These are important aspects. Okay, next one. Higher the PQLI, more is the economic development. If a country's PQLI is higher, that means what? Economic development is high. Lower PQLI, that means what? Lesser economic development. Very simple. Lower PQLI, lesser economic development. Higher PQLI, that means more economic development. These all are important aspects of PQLI. Now next one. Positive aspects. Positive aspects of the PQLI. These positive aspects are positive aspect. First one, PQLI includes factors like literacy, life expectancy, and that one, last one is it what? Infant mortality rate. So these all three aspects which touch the standard of human life. These all are close touch with the human life. So it is positive aspect. We are discussing about the positive aspects. Positive, that means only favorable points we will discuss, not unfavorable. Clear? Because I said it, each and every coin has two sides. One side will be positive and second side will be negative. So now we are discussing only these positive facts or positive aspects which are in PQLI. Clear? You can say importance of PQLI. You can write here importance of PQLI. Then also we will write same. And why PQLI is better than per capita income as an indicator. Compared to growth rate of per capita income, PQLI is better. Why? Another question, importance of PQLI. Next one question, positive aspects of PQLI. Then we write same answer, okay? PQLI includes factors like literacy, life expectancy, and infant mortality rate, which are the touch the standard of human life. First one. Second one is the PQLI is better index when compared to per capita income index. If we are comparing with whom? With which? If we are comparing, listen, compared to growth rate of national income, per capita, growth rate of per capita income is better. Clear? Compared to per capita income of a country, growth rate of per capita income, PQLI is better. Then next third, PQLI as an indicator of economic development has, when we are, second one, we are comparing to only per capita income, then it will be better. Okay. Third one, PQLI is an indicator of the economic development has lesser drawbacks. Lesser, it has lesser drawbacks compared to national income. It's just against the, remember this thing, okay? National income and per capita income related indicators, it has lesser drawbacks. Next one, with PQLI comparisons can be made between different countries. Okay, if you want to compare, I say between different countries, and comparison can be done with different group of the countries. Group of the countries, that means what? European countries, Asian countries, like that. Okay, so different group of countries or different states of the same country, we can easily compare. So it makes comparison very easy. Next one and last point is, we can create PQLI for urban rural, for male female. If we want to create PQLI, we can create only for the urban area, only for the rural area, then for male, female, and other comparison also, if you want, we can be do. We can be create a different PQLI for that. Okay. Next, limitations. These limitations are, first limitation is what? Only three aspects are here. Only three aspects. We are just discussing. First one indicator like literacy. Second one indicator is life expectancy. Last one is infant mortality. Only by these three aspects we are comparing these countries and we are giving that category: better, badder, lower, or highway, or more developed, like that. So with the help of only three aspects, how we can say? So it is the limitation. It is the drawback of that. Okay. We are creating a picture of a country. We are creating a picture of the state or different group of country only with the help of these three aspects. All other factors also if affecting to human being, to their standard of life. But we are not discussing any other aspect. We are just as we are just create this PQLI with the help of three determinants. So it is a limitation or drawback. Third one, just per capita income. We are saying compared to per capita income, it is better. But per capita income also an average, and this one also an average, which has divided by whatever total we will get by these three indicators. This value will be obtained from that three indicators. It will be divided by three, and that average, whatever we will get, that is the per PQLI. That means it is just like an average. So it is second limitation. Third one. If a country's per present PQLI is high, it cannot be generalized that the economic development is high as against other countries. Present only. Suppose last year that country's PQLI is low and this present PQLI is high. So we will say that country is higher developing country compared to all other and against to all other countries. So it is a limitation. Only we are comparing with present PQLI. Okay. Third one is, it's not right to give equal weightage because of equal weightage to all these three. We had given equal weightage to all these three aspects. All these three aspects has 100-100 weightage. I said this time, when I explained this that time, I said this one. All these three indicators will get 100-100 weightage. But all three have different value in human life. So how we can give same weightage to all this? It is a drawback. Fifth one, growth of income has high importance. Growth of income, how our country's people's growth rate is increasing. But we are not discussing anything for that. Clear? If a country's growth rate of income is increasing, how it's affecting, we ignored in the PQLI. So it is very it is drawback of that. Okay, clear? In the PQLI we have ignored it. What we have ignored? Income. Growth rate of income has ignored in this. And it is very, it cannot possible. It is wrong. Okay. Or it is, you can say, drawback of this. Now next one is the last one, the PQLI of rich countries rise at a slower rate. Which countries are rich? Like Norway is very developed country, but its country's PQLI will be rise at slower rate. Why? Because of they already use the natural and human resources. Now they are searching for the new type of resources. Due to that reason, that country's PQLI will increase, but by very slow rate, because average life expectancy cannot increase beyond a particular limit. Suppose that country's life expectancy has 100. After 100, how it will be increased? So everything has a particular limit, and we are ignoring in this. So it is the drawback of that. I hope you all have understood. And if you have any query, any doubt, please message me personally. Thank you. We will meet again in the next video.